episode, Krishna was allowed to look after the calves. So Krishna, although we seen before that this is according to Varnashram system, that although Krishna is son of a powerful, wealthy man, Nanda Maharaj, as soon as he was able to take care of the calves, he was sent to the fields with their friends, with the other boys, in order to perform that duty. So this is looks like he, this is the best way to treat a child. It looks like it, this is a situation. And now this Leela just started. Yesterday's verse was about how Krishna and the cowherd boys they would enjoy in Vraj. And now is a particular Leela is starting now. So this Leela, in this Leela, Srila Prabhupada points for the word Mugdha, that Krishna pretends to be without knowing, to be unaware. But of course we know that that is impossible. We know Krishna is aware of every leaf that is falling from a tree, is aware of everything in the creation, in the spiritual world. But no one can understand who Krishna, how exactly Krishna is. So this is a bewildering only for the conditioned souls. It is very difficult for us to have a glimpse. So that's why it's so important to hear from pure devotees. Because these two verses here, they can say, they can induce so much in a pure devotee. He can, as we before we heard from so many devotees, and especially Dinabandhu Prabhu, he introduced to us a portrait of Vrindavan. So this portrait of Vrindavan that we heard is from his experience there, and so devotees by offenseless chanting, they get a transcendental experience. And then the best position for a devotee, as we learn, is to be eager to render service to these devotees and be close to them. Because in this little shloka, one pure devotee, he can give so much. He can give so much about colors, about bodily gestures, about dialogues. Even we hear from texts, from many pure devotees, the six Goswamis, and we also hear what was Krishna thinking. So they add this information, and that is all bona fide if it's coming from a pure devotee. So this pastime, it will end very soon, only two shlokas more. And the way to approach this pastime is by a pure devotee. And as for us, we are aspiring devotees, we are practicing every day as much as we can sadhana bhakti. We know Krishna points himself in the Bhagavad Gita, the reason for his appearance, paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskitam dharma samsapanartaya sambhavami yuge yuge. So, the first line, we understand that this is a very close relationship that Krishna established with his devotee. He comes to deliver his devotee and also to annihilate the demons and miscreants. So this is very, this we are now getting a glimpse of this in these Leelas. And secondly, Krishna points that he comes to establish the Dharma, the principles of religion. And this this every day we get in contact with this by the words of the Bhagavad Gita, by the philosophy that Srila Prabhupada very kindly introduced to us in a very deep way. So this way of behaving, this Dharma that Krishna comes to establish, this we get in touch to this in one way, deeper or shallow, every day. We must get in touch with this in the classes. So this is our studies in Bhagavad Gita. There is so many topics about the material world, about the modes of material world, about the renunciation, karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, the nature of the soul in this world. So many things are there, the types of renunciation, the types of austerity. So we get guided by this. But now at this point, we are entering in Krishna's Leela, in this 10th canto. So this is another subject. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you would say that the Leela, it is there in order to attract the heart of the conditioned soul. Otherwise, there would be no point. Krishna's Leela, Krishna's form, Krishna's activities can even attract the self-realized souls in this world. It can even give the taste. It can give taste to the hearts. So all these Leelas, they are very special. Although they are small, they are very special because they clean the heart. If we hear from them in the proper way. And material affection is very strong. There is the creeper of devotional service. This creeper is so 500 years ago, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu introduced this topic, the Sankirtan movement was exploding in that time. And many devotees, many great souls, many pure souls were surrendering, and they were manifesting their pure love for Krishna. All the Goswamis, all the acharyas that came after, manifest in such a pure way. And in our times, as Kali Yuga advanced a little more, and as we all the devotees, all senior devotees, they try to go further. Into Srila Prabhupada's movement in the Western world, that is much more harder to dig and to introduce by book distribution, by so many temple activities that must be kept very paka, very, very nicely. So as we do this, we have to be in an environment that is very much material. So the way to maintain this bhakti, the creeper of devotional service, it is not. If it wasn't for Krishna's mercy, we could not understand it developing. But somewhere or another, we see that it is developing. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said, all of you know. That this creeper is kept by the watering of listening and chanting and listening. So this is like this pastimes. If we hear from them in a pure way, they have this effect. So some pastime, I could not understand precisely. I was understanding conflict informations, and I asked my Guru Maharaj, it seems when I hear this and when I hear that, it seems that it doesn't much fit. So how should I understand this point? My Guru Maharaj he told me, well, some things we just have to appreciate. So this Leela, when it comes from a pure devotee, a devotee that is practicing very seriously, this is a benefit. We really appreciate. And this appreciation, it is not material, because in material terms, we can never understand what is going on. We can never understand how Krishna does this, how the devotees would react like this, how this is very wonderfully presented.